You know, I'm getting into this because when we first bought here 17 years ago, it was Mayberry on the lake. And the first 4th of July, I almost cried. It was so wonderful. My neighborhood was great. The kids could ride their bikes, do whatever they wanted. We looked after each other with our neighbors. That's changed in the past few years. And I just don't like it. I feel like there's some loud, shrill voices that are not letting other people be heard. And my hope is if we all are successful in the election that, as we've talked about, we'll cooperate, we'll bring back some common courtesy and respect for each other, and even if we disagree, we'll work through our differences for the good of the town.
Well, that's exactly where I'm from. I've owned my home out here for over 40 years, and up until the last 3 or 4 years, just like you said, everybody got along fine. It was like you said, Mayberry. And for some reason or other, I mean, I was looking the other day and I see, like, for instance, our legal fees in this town. 3 years ago, we were around $17,000 a year, and lo and behold, last year they were over $110,000, $111,000. We've already spent about $55,000 this year. It's unsustainable. I mean, I'd rather spend that money improving the stops, the parks, you know, some of the infrastructure here in town instead of fighting each other. I mean, it's ridiculous. I don't know. What do you guys think?
I totally agree. This is a world-class community. My wife and I started our lives here 30 years ago and raised our family in this community, and it's a great place. But currently, things just aren't, they're just not clicking. This town isn't working. It's not working for the people.
Well, I think first thing the town needs is really a comprehensive master plan to decide where it is we're going. We need to be reviewing and modernizing zoning and town ordinances in order to provide really consistent enforcement. I've lived here for 38 years, raised 4 children. Now I'm at a point in my life where I am busy, but I think it's time to turn back to the community and provide that which the community has provided me for all these years.
Well, you know, I kind of feel the same way. When I was transferred back here to Northern Indiana in 1995, and my wife and I decided we really wanted to build our new home in Long Beach. Why? Because it was a great beach community, had a reputation for friendliness and neighborliness, and that was very attractive to us. Now it's not that way. I mean, it's so bad now that when I was talking to a few friends about possibly considering running for the town council, their initial comment to me was, "Are you crazy?" And I said, "No." I said, "I just think if you can't be part of the solution, you're part of the problem." And as far as I'm concerned, I'm in it. I'm in it here to stay. I hope that I can convince you that I can be on this council and that you will support me. But I think that we need to bring this town back to the town that it had the great reputation for.
I totally agree with the comprehensive plan for the town. We need to have a plan that's going to take us 10, 20 years into the future. We need to know where we're going. And there's some issues out there from fire protection, police protection, the community center, possibly sewers. I know I look back on the ordinances and the plans back. I think it was first mentioned in 1972. That's when they first started talking about city sewers. I mean, these are issues we're going to have to talk about, and that should all be part of that comprehensive plan and where we want to be 10, 20 years in the future.
And I think that's the source of an awful lot of the grief that goes on in the town today, is you have a group of people who are just kind of aimlessly wandering into the future and with no plan. So what happens? The bickering starts.
Exactly. And I think that, you know, there are serious problems out here, and there are serious issues that you just mentioned that have to be addressed. But you never get anywhere, and you never get anything done if you don't have a plan. You just simply wander in one direction, and when the ball bounces in another direction, you go that direction. Ultimately, you don't make any progress.
Well, all we got to do is we've got to make sure we work together.
Yeah.
And that's the key right there, and that's what's not happening today. I mean, getting back to the fighting and the bickering, and it's a great gravy train for the lawyers. You can't blame the lawyers. I'm a lawyer. I know how this all works. And call up the lawyer, and he said, okay. And so then you got to research something and prepare something, and you get billable time, and then the client gets to pay the bill. And we're paying the bill, and I think we could spend some of that money for the beautification of this community, update it like you say, and let's go forward and work together. That's what I'm saying. I don't know why we can't do that.